Hey, what's up? So, Killing for Company. My name's Kellen. Today, I've got something a little bit different for you. I've got a package here from Rick over at the Dreadful Minutes. He sent this my way, and I've obviously opened it and taken a quick peek inside, but I haven't really gone through it thoroughly. I wanted to save all of that for this video. So before we get into that, just wanted to say thank you very much to Rick. He sent me a message, you know, saying if I'd be interested in a CD a while back, and I said, sure. You know, I haven't had a whole lot of opportunity to do any VCLT stuff with the community here on YouTube, and even when I started the channel, I did not know just how common that was, and if anyone would watch my videos, be interested in sending anything. So it was really, really kind, and he said that I didn't, you know, should not feel obligated to send anything back his way, but no. I also would like to kind of jump back into this and kind of get the ball rolling. Maybe I would get a chance in the future to do that more and more and sort of build those relationships with people here on YouTube. And just a quick little note about this whole VCLT thing. When I was really, you know, getting into music, a lot of it was during that, a lot of music I listened to was through just digital download. It's just a product of, you know, where my age and what was happening at the time. And I think that's, you know, important because I was not, like, I did not take into consideration something like becoming a collector of music, much less a collector of metal and punk, which brings me to what's playing in the background. This is Fane, really intense, charged punk. We're out of Vancouver, BC. I think Pat over at Ground Zero Salem, not much will no longer be of Salem. I know he's in the process of moving, but shout out to Pat. Hope your movie's going well. Mine's finishing up over here, and yeah, so on Phobia Records. Anyway, but back to the point. I did not get into the, or I was not listening to music with the intention of being a music collector. That's something that happened a bit more, that happened later in life, at least that I was collecting music with a sense of intention. And the reason I point that out is that what did matter to me during that, you know, digital era of music, first and foremost, was, yes, the music, but also being able to share it with people. And I don't mean like on an online MP3 download sense, but being able to talk about it with people. The crowd, you know, you'd show up and you'd get a chance to meet people at a show, and it wasn't like conversations about whether you had it on vinyl or CD or cassette or anything like that. I wasn't having conversations about collecting music, but I was having conversation about, have you heard this? Did you get to see them live? And was able to build a sense of community in the process. That was what was most important. And it wasn't necessarily like a material connection to the music, right? It was just, we were just getting digital downloads, but me and my peers, my friends, you show up to a show, you don't know anyone, but there's a good chance you probably heard what they were, you know, something either from one of the bands at the concert, or had heard it on YouTube, or had something else to discuss. It created a sense of community that was really important, and I think that's what's great about the VCLT. Like, and even to YouTube on, in this sense that I don't necessarily have, you know, much of a concern or focus as to how much material items I have, but being able to share whatever I do have in my possession with other people and have that kind of conversation, like, that's great. And you know, this is an opportunity to kind of give back and participate in that. So anyway, just a quick note on that, and let's get into this package here. So we'll open this up and check it out. You can tell, well cared for. I will try and go through this as in a controlled and coherent fashion here, but I also see how awkward I can make this. So this is well kept together here. We'll just go through an editing process if, when I'm looking at this video again, how long it's gonna take, but. I can tell Rick has done this before, just to how. Okay. Satfras. I think this is the one that he sent me, or sent a photo of. Right? I think this was supposed to be Doom. I've never heard of this band. I don't know this band. I hope it is Doom, because I'm kind of wrapping up this Cut Your Teeth series. Hopefully, I'll shoot the last video next weekend, but until then, I've just been spending so much time studying death metal, I'm like interested to make a little bit of a change in the listening habits. So hope this is Doom. That'll give me something to listen to, because the fall is here and I'm in that kind of a mood. So anyway, I will post all the, either my research after I get done with this video, and post something where I have links so you get like proper names and titles and all the information if you are interested in anything that I show here today. But anyway, so Satverus writes, okay, awesome. Moving on. A Pan American Native Front promo tape. Very cool. I mean, is there a, I know when Rick was concerned, like, I don't know how much of this you'll actually have in your possession when I send it to you, but I don't own, so far, any of these, and, what can you say, like, Pan American Native Front is one of the larger names in American black metal this year, so, thank you, Rick. Moving on. I also did want, I wasn't gonna open that up and show all the cards and stuff like that. We'll just show off the items here. Whoa, okay. Witching, Venril. Don't know this one either. So a bunch of, I mean, I know the Pan American Native Front, but so far the two CDs are brand new to me. That's some wild album artwork. I don't know the sheen here. I'll have to like show a photo afterwards of all this stuff so people can look. How long do you think it'll take me if I pull this out? I just want to show you the album artwork. Screw it, I'm moving on. I don't want to do this because it takes too long. Okay, anyway, but Witching Venril, yeah, the glare is probably gonna show up, so I'm sorry about that, but that's some, a super cool album artwork. Anyway, we'll capture that in a photo later. Yes, okay. Got a little stickers here. That is a... We have Night Shift. Share and tag your order. Be entered to win a $50 gift card each month. Night Shift merch. Our little... I think that's King of the Hill. Mall. I think that's their compilation. Hold on a second. Since he sent me this, I just want to... I'll edit this. Hold on. Okay, I believe this is the accompanying record. I don't know you have this, Rick. Hell, do you want this? I mean... I don't want to give this away. I take it back. Can you do that in the VCLT? Okay. But anyway, maybe down the road. I just got this recently, so I feel a little bit hesitant about giving it away. And Mall's an awesome American death metal band, but nonetheless, that caught my eye. Thinking alike. I mentioned to Rick that... You know, I just moved, and like many people who just move, it's an expense, right? It's gonna cost you something, and I've been trying to sort of, I also bought like some new, like a new record player and some new hi-fi stuff, so, I have a sticker here. So I mentioned to Rick that I probably was gonna try and watch my spending habits for music for the rest of at least the next, you know, to the end of the year. Okay, what do we have here? So this is 7-inch. Grave Fire. Beast Unburdened by Flesh. Little Iron Bonehead. I think that's on black. I'm gonna try and take my time with this. One of the things that I'm always envious about Rick is you can tell he's in like a design profession because he savors like the artwork during his presentation and when he's talking about it. I kind of feel like, you know, I'm just fumbling through actually presenting the artwork and the material without any kind of appreciation or understanding of the effort that went involved in putting it together. I would describe it like, I once saw a kid in a grocery store, like they had cakes on display, and this little kid was like in a shopping cart, and as his parent sort of walked by the pastries, the kid just stuck his hand out and just like took a massive handful of cake, just threw it in his mouth. Cheers, like well done, little man. But anyway, I feel like that's how I present artwork. You know, just like this greedy, disrespectful way of consuming artwork. Anyway, Rick, no, he's a connoisseur. He would savor that cake. Greedy little child hands grabbing a cake in the middle of the grocery store. Who raised you? Okay. All right. I think I've seen this one floating around. It's a Spiral, or I think Chasm is the name of this record. This is, I believe, on Sentient Ruin. The album artwork here is kind of muted or opaque. It's very sort of, you know, one color here. Yep, Sentient Ruin. It's the record label. I don't know. They do a lot of sort of like Black Death stuff. It's usually pretty good. Back when I had my radio show, they sent me a bunch of promo stuff. So I'm relatively familiar with the label and like a lot of the stuff they put out, which this is right in my wheelhouse. Well, just on black, we'll leave it in there for now. And That is fresh. Did you even listen to this, Rick? This feels like a brand new out of the... Okay. Anyway. That is just... Or someone who truly cares about the content of their... That they're buying isn't, you know, fumbling around. There's a... Oh, man. There's even a download code in here. You hooked me up. Okay, well, I will definitely listen to that. And once again, let's put this to the side and I won't try and do much more re-sleeving or anything like that. Okay, I'm flip the record. Hold on. Okay. Another vinyl record. Dawnbringer. Actually, don't... So I know Dawnbringer. I don't actually own anything by them. So this will be something to dive into. I think this is just on black. But I don't have an album title here. So maybe I'll show that off and people can yell at me in the comments for not knowing my Dawnbringer. What's the one that is like band I know? I believe Marty on his channel, him and Alan, what do I recognize? Chris Black, is that his name? I'd be wrong about that. Let me consult the Oracle. Okay, I was right, Chris Black. The guy behind this, drummer in Pharaoh and as is hands and a whole bunch of other really cool American metal projects. I'm loving that new Pharaoh record. And I'll probably, I have not done a single like one album review on this channel yet. Maybe I should do it for the Pharaoh record. Nonetheless, Dawnbringer, I'm off, like super pumped to have this in my collection. Next time I get a chance to talk to you, Rick, hopefully I'll have spun this, you know, a handful of times and be able to talk to you about it. Okay, what do we have next? Whoa! So this has seen some love and some spins, it looks like, depending on the sleeve. Korra? If I had to guess, based on, this looks proggy. The color template here says prog to me. And we've got all sorts of different monsters, eyes, celestial doors, cosmic themes. Yeah, I'm gonna say this was progressive death metal. I don't know this project at all. Korra and Timaeus? Timaeus? I have no idea. But once again, pretty cool album artwork there. Hopefully that spares some of the glare from the jacket, but looks like on black. Sweet. I've never heard of that band. Thank you very much, Rick. Goes into the listening pile. Complete blind walking into that one, but if there's a keyboardist who wants to be Paganini, I won't be surprised. Okay. Last one here. This is like fresh clean. This is still... He's got a little note here for me. Ben Katzman's Degreaser, Quarter Life Crisis. Something fun to listen to. Kind of punk and rock. His shtick is astrology. Interesting. Huh. It says here on the hype sticker, produced by Colleen Green, ignored by Pitchfork. Oh, they're so snobby. Vice and Rolling Stone, loved by people who like to shred. Okay. Sweet. That is interesting. It's kind of got Kiss like in the background there. Interesting. If I were to like just myself look at that, I would definitely say a bit more like indie garage rock, noise rock stuff, but that's my take. Nonetheless, okay. The gauntlet has been thrown down. So Rick has given me a package here and some ideas in terms of how to do this. Nonetheless, like what, like if you are not watching The Dreadful Minutes, you need to. Rick is a pillar of the VCLT online YouTube community. Just one of the nicest people I've had a chance to interact with here, and his kindness has been, you know, like in terms of someone who was welcoming and, you know, wanted to sort of reach out and make me feel like I was a part of the community. Like, I can't say enough good things about him. This is really cool. I cannot wait to listen to these records. My wife is currently out with a friend this evening, so I just have the place to myself and have been playing vinyl all day. So those records are going to head onto the record player as soon as this video wraps. And I get now to put together a package for you. I know it's not an obligation or whatever, but I'm looking forward to it. I'd actually, more than anything, trying to like get your opinion on some stuff, things that I haven't been able to kind of wrap my head around in terms of how to talk about it. And hopefully, with your background and knowledge, you'll be able to throw something my way and we can compare notes. So either way, thank you so much, Rick. Anyone who's been watching the Cut Your Teeth series and taking the time to comment, like I truly appreciate it. It's been a lot of fun, but it's also probably the most comprehensive thing I've done on YouTube. So I'm looking forward to sort of being able to walk away from it and give you something different if you are ready to kind of step away from death metal and get ready here for the fall and the winter, which will sort of alter my my taste in metal. So, and we're kind of getting close to the end of the year, so I've really been trying to catch up on all my 2021 records, and hopefully, you know, the rest of the year, I haven't talked about any new stuff, so I'm thinking the rest of the year is just going to be like collection update, maybe a few sort of concept ideas for videos, and jumping in through the live streams. Oh, that, you know, if you were not, Rick primarily does the Saturday night live streams. There's a name for the crew, but I don't know. I off top, I don't know. I apologize. But there's a group of YouTubers who get together on Saturday night mostly, and around 9:30 or so, and Rick usually is running the show in terms of using his channel as the platform to live stream. So if you want to like have nothing to do on a Saturday night and want to hear people talk about music that they love, you should check The Dreadful Minutes for Rick's content, also for the live streams. And anyway, that's all I got for you. Thank you so much, Rick, once again. And I will be putting together a package here for you to send out your way and keep this thing going. So that's all. I'll see you guys later. Bye.